Yeah.
America.
Because Swedish people don't act like that. They're not violent. Alright, so... we were stuck before. I decided I would reload so that I could retry this. And we'll see if, the game will decide to work. I doubt it, but, you know. Give them a benefit of a doubt. Because if you don't give somebody that, what do you have left? Some nerd on the internet bullshit. That's what. Sheena is a punk rocker now. Let's see if this works. Rest in peace. You know what? I'm not gonna replay this entire game again just because of this shitty ass glitch. I mean, I don't know. Maybe Chicago Bread knows the true way. This isn't looking good. I don't know, Bread. I don't know how many back doors there are in this place. I mean, maybe in the basement? Let's check the basement. I don't need to go to... okay. Really, Simon? Because there's no other way out of here. Okay. Mr. Know-it-all. Well, I hate to say it, but I think this is the end of our game. Not that there were that many people watching, but, you know, if you watched to this point, you were obviously a fan. And for that, I thank you, and I'm sorry that it had to end this way. Wait, there's a door there. How do we get to that door? Thank you. I'm retarded. Okay, well, if you're still watching at this point, thanks for putting up with me being a dummy. I don't quite remember where my flashlight is, but we'll just load up on guns. It is daylight out. And boy, did I screw his face up. Okay, so we got a Ruger, the Glock, some drugs. I don't know, maybe I'll regret this, but we're gonna go Rambo. Now, I do have saves before we give the doctor the gun, in case I wanted to come back and try and get a better ending. Oh, a different ending. Because as undoubtedly you saw, I was researching how you get the different endings a little bit. So I'm on track to get the best one. And I mean, you can YouTube the rest. Did I miss out on a revolver? Oh, you know what? I bet if you don't give him a pistol, then he probably just uses a revolver in that fight. I guess. Makes sense. I don't think we need this. Unless, like, the sun goes out. I'm feeling really peaceful right now. Oh, it's beautiful. It's like Resident Evil 4. Oh no, this is Silent Hill 2. If you remember, towards the end of the game, James needs to get to the hotel on the water. And so he steals a rowboat and rows across. Generally the same idea as this, even though it's entirely the same camera angle. Although maybe it was slanted when he does it, but it was foggy in his scene. But it's an interesting parallel that they're both returning to the start of it all. Well, actually, no, this is the end of our hero's journey. Well, James's was completing the circle, really. Good old Silent Hill 2. Which reminds me, the HD collection's coming out. I think I'll have to pick that up. Might even do a let's play of that. Oh god, Icy, I forgot to tell him. Let's break the immersion there. Probably just like that dumbass. I don't think so. Icy's a pretty nice guy. Kinda surprised nothing attacked us, but it's okay. I'll take it. That was my cell phone. It's an email for me. Oh boy, Comic-Con badges are on sale on the 3rd. That could have gone better. This could have gone better. Well. Okay, this is so far so good. I'm kinda regretting not grabbing the syringe, but it's okay. Ammo's better in the long run. At the same time, it is kinda dark. Actually, I'm kind of curious if you guys can even see, but... I'll try and use up my shotgun ammo so that... I can drop and get a lantern. I mean, it might be okay if you put on HD, but... Okay, we're going into a sewer. Shit. I might as well grab that lantern. Do this. My favorite place in the world, sewers. I was wondering if he was gonna go down. Shotgun there, right? Oh, hey, swimming sections! Did I tell you how much I love swimming? It's even better than... Oh god. Sorry, I've got oxygen up here. close. Luckily our hero has a lungs like a fish. Shit. Come on, come on, come on. Actually, I didn't realize at the time, but our stamina was going down, so let's just let it recharge. Alright. I'm wondering if it's scripted to choke, because we definitely had more than enough time to go through all that. Oh, how I'd hate to have to do all of that over again. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little worried. Oh my god. We'll try the other direction. I'd hate to have a repeat of the incident where I should've used all my ammo on him and realized he couldn't die. There was definitely an item on the ground, but seeing as he's camping the spot, we're not gonna get it. I just did a circle by accident. Yeah. Not a circle, but went backwards. Oh no. So that dude is guarding a key. But I don't think we can get by him. Full of lead and see if he falls over. It's not like I've seen any keys in the ground. So. Oh, we swam all the way backwards. Whoops. Interestingly enough, we can sprint while underwater, but it doesn't make us go any faster. You know, I'm starting to think that you can't drown. And it only happens when you start to go up towards a air pocket. So to test that, let's hang down here for a little bit. Okay, I'm wrong. I guess ultimately, if I can't knock him down, then I'm gonna have to reload, make sure my inventory has a free spot, and just run up and grab whatever's on the ground there. Okay, we're down a gun, but we have a key. Thankfully, he disappeared. Unless he's swimming in this water. No. Not that his chance will be able to work, but he could certainly just grab us and drown us. Anyway, at least we're making progress. Oh. Please let me out of this hellhole. Forced. Oh, look. Let me just wave my gun around my hometown. Not having my guns now. Oh, just like real life, people just leave guns sitting all around. I thought they weren't even supposed to have guns in Sweden, let alone leave ammo around for little kids to find. God, just like Sweden in real life. Okay, he's down, we're safe. Thank you. Jeez, armed to the teeth. I think I'd rather have this. Just because it has more shots, really. Probably gonna need the sledgehammer, but oh, okay. And all this revolver ammo makes me wish I had a revolver, because I probably picked up a good... probably the 20 bullets. And I've almost exhausted this gun's clip, so... oh. Speak of the devil. Kind of peculiar. See, if this was Silent Hill 2, you could say that monster represented some fragment of our hero's psyche. But this game isn't that deep. We certainly got enough ammo. Brodingstrujonston. Just like Mama always told me. Alright, something's gonna probably pop through that door, so let's be prepared. Surprise, surprise. Lots of surprises thus far. I almost think there was a boss coming up. Shame I don't have my shotgun, but it's okay. Really wasn't that great.
Finally home. I hope Mom's okay.
Mater, I'm coming, Mater. Look, people can just run up and look in your bathroom. Yeah.
Mom? Mom! Where are you? Mom? Mom!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, mother. And then she was in a rocking chair, mummified. Here comes the big plot twist. Wasn't that the room? A Browning wheelchair magazine with 13 rounds? Okay, well, we're in a wheelchair. Oh yeah, this was the cordoned off department building. Oh. It's actually kind of neat. Thank goodness we've got our Browning wheelchair magazine. It would actually be kind of interesting if his life bar was our life bar, which it might be. Okay, it's not. Shit. I kind of goofed on that, my bad. Not there. Oh, we can't skip this. Face my own demons. There we go. I said, there we go. Alright, I just had to restart the game, because from what I've heard is if you have the game longer, well, on for long periods of time, it starts to get glitchier and glitchier. And from what we just saw with the whiteout and the lack of control, we might have run into that. So, we're going to go back to hunting for ourselves. Come on. So, backing up is no good. So it seems like our best bet is to charge forward and kill ourselves. Yeah. I said that. That's our plan. We're just gonna shoot ourselves in the face. He's gonna spawn on the left side. See, I'm hoping that going diagonally across the hallway will be enough dodging to warrant him missing a lot. We took minimal amounts of damage. Let's keep it up. Because we all have to face our demons someday. Not like Simon, where we can just, you know. Oh god. Okay, we got our shit pushed in while he shot us to death. If we happen to die, then I will know to reload before we get there. Doing too good. I think we have enough bullets. Damn it. Unfortunately for us, we don't get any syringes in this section. If only I'd reloaded, I would have been fine. Alright, I'm gonna edit this. Well, if I remember to. I'm not going to, though. Sorry, guys. So our best bet is to stay reloaded and shoot him as much as we can. I mean, I guess I really shouldn't have expected much strategy from this section, considering we're in a wheelchair, so... Let's finish the fight. It's happening again. Oh, cool. I kind of wish we'd gotten a chance to save closer to where we start the fight, because kind of irritating, but if I remember to, I'll edit this out so to save you guys from this torture. Stop biting my nail. ourselves. So far, so good. Should be the dark hallway coming up. I don't know why I never go for the pot shot there, but it's okay. I think we definitely have enough health this time. To kill ourselves. Faced our demons and won. What does this mean for our hero, though?
I stopped myself from doing it, from committing suicide. But it didn't only leave me alive, it also left two police officers dead. I killed them, shot them both. This was not supposed to happen. Doctors testified that I was having a psychosis. Which means that my punishment won't be too hard for me to bear. I have to spend the rest of my life in a mental hospital. Where nurses and doctors are taking care of me. They let me finish my book, and it has helped me a lot. I wrote a happy ending, just for myself. I feel better now. I am more at peace with myself, even though I'm still stuck in this wheelchair. But
I don't quite understand, but okay.
I can never forgive myself for shooting those two officers, though. But I have so many supportive people around me now, so...
I could have sworn we shot Dr. Purnell, but... I think we'll be okay.
Dr. Purnell is mentoring me and is watching my progress.
So if I have to guess, I guess we were actually living his story.
Sophie visits me every once in a while. When the doctors let her, that is. They still think her visits are too destabilizing for me and that it hinders my progress. I keep on telling her how sorry I am for making her life miserable every time she's here. She just laughs a bit and tells me to stop being so silly. But I can see the damage I've done to her in her eyes every time she looks at me. She found a new friend. One who is there for her and treats her right. I'm happy for her. Though... I'll miss the good moments we've had, knowing that they'll never come back. I think this is a good time to close this book.
Well, good job, Simon.
It has changed my
life.
You
conquered your demons and you didn't shoot yourself.
The end.
All because I decided to kill every boss and I never ran away. I'm the shit. Thank you, Andreas Dronenberg. I'm not gonna watch the credits, but I would like to say thank you to those of you who stuck it out to the end. This is my first real Let's Play. I'm not gonna count dinner date. But yeah, I do it for the fans. Yeah. Really, I like to see that people watch my videos. If someone out there derives pleasure from watching, then that's enough, you know? Otherwise, I wouldn't spend 10 hours uploading every video, because my upload rate sucks. But, yeah, all in all, this game was surprisingly long, surprisingly fun, and surprisingly well made. I mean, there are some issues with the AI, and if you have the game on for too long, things start to get a little glitchy, but I think I can forgive that pretty easily, considering A, this game is free, and B, it's a conversion for Half-Life. A total conversion, might I add. So, yeah. Hope you enjoyed Cry of Fear. This is Reverend Claude Huggins, signing off. Oh, these are final stats. In case you wanted to see how bad I did. Yeah.